let's say, our first experience with electrical impedance tomography in ALI patients, and the use we did of it, trying to set mechanical ventilation according to its findings. First of all, I have very few conflict of interests, and let me try to explain to you what is electrical impedance tomography, how does it work, and what does it measure. I have to say that I am a physician, I'm not an engineer, so I will tell you what I understood of it, and you have plenty of engineers at the Dräger booth that can explain you better. So, but from a physician point of view, let's say that in the thorax there are different tissues with different electrical properties, and air in lungs has a very high impedance to electricity. So, starting from this concept, EIT applies alternating electric current from 16 electrodes placed around the patient thorax with the belt. And a current is applied between two electrodes, while the rest of the electrodes registers the signal coming from this current. So basically, if you have the first current applied to these two, the others will get a signal based on the impedance that is of what is contained in the thorax. Then the current is switched from a couple to another couple of electrodes, and the signal is registered again from the rest of the electrodes. So basically, if you have a region with increased impedance in a place inside the field of view of the electro belt, you will have a set of current that will pass through and will identify this region. Then you have some algorithm of reconstruction, and you will get an image that is similar to this. So basically, the electrical properties of these zones makes it visible from the outside, non-invasively, radiation-free. In fact, EIT is a non-invasive, radiation-free bedside imaging method that can give us cross-sectional, instant in-motion images of ventilation. PulmoVista is a new device by Dräger that is commercially available and is the EIT system that we use on our patients. This is one of our patients. We place this belt with the 16 electrodes around the thorax. And basically, I hope this will work, what you see is this. So this is one of our ALI patients. And you see, move the end. You see, this is normal ventilation on pressure support. And we can say this is end of expiration, while this is more or less end of inspiration. So at the end of expiration, there is no air movement, so no recording of changes in impedance. This is why it's all black. It's not that there is no air in that. There is no change in air content. At the end of inspiration, the impedance increases, so the blue and the white comes out, and you have a maximum that is reached at the end inspiration, and then expiration starts and it goes back to black. So it's not that black is no air, it's no air motion. And the output that you get on the screen of the PulmoVista is this, and basically this is a summary of all the information you can get clinically from your patient that gets this EIT machine on. Basically, you have the image that we saw before this, this will be the actual image that will show inspiration, expiration. This is a graph with the time and changes in impedance. Okay, so you have inspiration, expiration, and it's zero to end expiratory impedance. And these are regions of interest that you can decide how to set. And for our studies, we decided to keep these four regions of interest that allowed us to detect changes in EIT data output between ventral and dorsal regions of the lung and left to right, because ALI is a very heterogeneous disease or syndrome, and it's not only, at least in patient ventral to dorsal, the problem is also left to right. So we thought that this could fairly detect changes in ventilation. So concluding this introduction, very simple and schematic and not very deep, but breath EIT through the Pulmovista is a breath by breath monitoring of ventilation. Why is it important to monitor ventilation at the bedside or in our ALI RDS patient? Because ventilation, as Dr. Valenza showed us before this afternoon, can be dangerous because there is ventilator-induced lung injury. And we focused on the development of ventilator-induced lung injury by the presence of heterogeneity in ventilation of our ALI patients. What is the role of heterogeneity? Again, Dr. Valenza showed this briefly before. We have this study that is published in 1970 by Dr. Mead from Boston. And they did a couple of models using condoms and springs, but I will show you the springs one. And and they showed how, because of the phenomenon of mechanical interdependence, ununiformly expanded lungs can develop heterogeneity in the distension, in the ventilation of the structures, so that you can have region with increased pressure, stress, strain, even in presence of fairly normal pressure, airway pressure. In the spring model, for example, they did this change. This is like a homogeneous lung. This will be a lung with a collapsed alveolus, for example, or with an overexpanded alveolus. And you can see that as the pressure around is always the same, there is no difference between these four images, but in the presence of a zone with a different characteristic in terms of homogeneity, of expansion, you have very different stress and pressure applied to the alveoli around. 30 years later, this was also shown in vivo by a model of mice. And in this study, through microscopy and other measures, they showed that both at zero pressure and at 24 centimeters of water of pressure, the ALI-RDS lung is very heterogeneous. And this is connected, associated with the development of VD. So to sum this part up, ARDS leads to presence of alveoli with different expansion characteristics. And in presence of tidal ventilation, we assist to end inspiratory differences in tidal vation distribution that leads to heterogeneity. And by the phenomenon of mechanical interdependence, this leads to regional differences in end inspiratory distending pressure, which can lead to very high distending pressure locally, even in the presence of a mean distending pressure that is within the limit of safety, for example. And this can lead to VD. So, can we measure ventilator heterogeneity that is maybe so important for the development of VD in our patients? Well, the gold standard is CT scans. And this is a study by Chairman Dr. Vlieg, showing that they could measure by CT scan regional heterogeneity in lungs and the influence of different ventilation strategies on heterogeneity. But maybe CT scan is difficult to be applied and cannot be daily practice. So maybe EIT may be a bedside radiation-free alternative to CT scans. And this is a first study reported, published in Critical Care in 2010, showing that maybe it's possible to set PEEP according to homogeneity or heterogeneity, that is the other side of the same coin, of lungs. And what they showed is that they build up a calculation of this GI index. I don't get into details, but basically this is inhomogeneity. So the least inhomogeneity may be related to the optimal PEEP in a PEEP trial. So maybe EIT is an alternative to CT, at least with many advantages, if this would be true. Bedside radiation free. So in this year, and with our first experience with this machine, with this technology, we measured if this was possible in some pilot studies. So we wanted to see if it is possible to measure heterogeneity and the influence of different ventilation strategy on heterogeneity in our ALI RDS patient by EIT. We focused on two ventilation settings. As from what we have seen before, heterogeneity is influenced by lung volumes and expiration that is related to PEEP, and that end inspiration that is related to pressure bore volume. So we performed two pilot studies on the influence of PEEP and support and volume settings on the heterogeneity of lungs of ALI patient measured by EAT in our 10-bed University Hospital General ICU, which is specialized in treatment of ARDS patients. How did we measure heterogeneity by EAT? By two methods. The first one is the relative distribution of tidal ventilation in the four regions of interest that I showed you before. For example, in this patient, you can see that a starting point, you have the four regions of interest and the relative distribution of the ventilation at end inspiration. Then you can do some mechanical ventilation setting chain that we will see, and you can get, for example, a redistribution towards the dorsal regions, as in this case, where you can see that ventilation increased in dorsal region. This is the first way we assessed it. The second is a more complex, in a sense, but it's very simple. Calculation of the standard deviation of the voxel level change in impedance indicized by the total or normalized by the total change in impedance of the imaged slice of the thorax. This is the formula, but basically is if you see on top there is the difference between inspiration and expiration in impedance and the sum of the whole slice and the standard deviation. Basically, if this is very close to the mean of all the voxel, the standard deviation will be very small. So the more the voxels are similar between each other, the less will be the heterogeneity, this value and the heterogeneity. Okay? This is not the perfect way. This is what we choose, then we thought that could be clinically relevant. So basically, we tested first the support by a pressure support study. We enrolled 11 patients with ALI RDS undergoing pressure support ventilation. We left PEEP and FiO2 as clinically set. We put on the EIT by the Pulmovista, and we choose the region of interest that I showed you. We randomized to high pressure support and low pressure support based on PO 0.1. This the characterization of the population. Basically, the pressure support ended up being 3 and 12. The tidal volume passed from 6.8 to 8.8. PO1 significantly changed, and so pH as the support was more, and PCO2. The first way, as that I told you, we measured its heterogeneity is the shift in ventilation between the four regions, and in more in particular, we concentrated on the ventral to dorsal redistribution, and we could see that in passing from a PS of a support of 12, so the high pressure support, to the support of 3, so the low pressure, the lower pressure support, we assisted to a redistribution from ventral to dorsal regions of the lungs. This is a way to see it, and this is another way to see the same result. So lung regions, ventral lung region, at higher pressure support, received more in the ventral and less in the dorsal. At the lower pressure support, the ventral went down in favor to the dorsal. And what about our global heterogeneity index, the standard deviation that I told you before? It changed, and passing through a lower pressure support, we assisted to a decrease significant in global heterogeneity. Interestingly, we could, with this technology, maybe we may be able to recognize patients which are not responding to our intervention, so no responders. The second study, I will go fast, as it's very similar. Basically, it's a PEEP study, 10 patients. PSV level in this case was not changed, NFiO2 too, and we did the same thing. One was clinically set PEEP. That could be either the high or the low, as if it was under 10, we increased it by 5. If it was over 10, we decreased it by 5. Again, characterization, so PEEP ended up being 8 and 13. Compliance slightly improved, PAV, airway pressure increased, PF ratio improved, and no change in pH or PCO2. Again, with increasing PEEP, so without any change in tidal volume, we assisted to a redistribution of ventilation towards dorsal region, passing from lower to higher PEEP levels. This is a way to see it. This is the other way. Again, higher PEEP levels, higher dorsal ventilation. And our general heterogeneity index significantly decreased with higher PEEP levels. And again, 2 non-responders to our treatment. In conclusion, from our pilot, but clinically maybe significant studies, we saw that ALI patients undergoing assisted mechanical ventilation, when PEEP is increased or PSV levels are decreased, we assist to a redistribution of tidal ventilation toward dorsal dependent lung regions, and a decrease in global heterogeneity. This, in time, may be related to VD. EIT may be useful to monitor ventilation heterogeneity at the bedside in ALI patients undergoing assisted mechanical ventilation, radiation-free and easy to be implemented every day, can be implemented in everyday practice. And EIT-based measures of heterogeneity may help in time. We are starting new studies on this to decide how to set mechanical ventilation in ALI patients to limit VD. Thank you.